हाय चिल्ड्रन, कमलीन, हाय, हेलो, प्रणय, आराध्या, गोरांश, हाय काव्या, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू योर ईवीएस क्लास. यू नो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू ओनली नोटबुक वर्क. ओके, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू बर्डन यू टुडे. आई विल नॉट टीच एनी लेसन. वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नोटबुक वर्क ऑफ चैप्टर 13. ओके, so today is 17th November 2020, Tuesday. We are actually dealing with our chapter 13, food and homes of animals, right? Food and homes of animals. Let me write. Food and homes of animals. Chapter 13 from your EVS. And password in food and homes of animals, let us fix password of one animal. Do you remember cow? Cow lives where? Home of cow? Do you remember? Home of cow called what? Kavleen, Pranay, Aradhya, Goransh, Kavya, who will tell me? What is the home of a cow called? Yes, shed. 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 Cow lives in shed. So today we are going to discuss only notebook work. Hi Anahita, welcome to your EVS class. If you can write along with me, you can start writing. Okay. Otherwise, also, I'm not going to pressure you. Just look at the board. I will send you the pics on the WhatsApp. Okay. Hi, Madhav. Welcome to your EVS class. So, in today's class, we are going to discuss the notebook work. First, keywords, then question and answers, then homes of animals. Okay. So, let me start with the keywords here. Keywords. With the keywords. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 keywords. Eight keywords. First is food and homes of animals. So, coming to food, we discussed about plant eaters, insect eaters, grain eaters. So, eaters. E-A-T-E. R-S, eaters, E-A-T-E-R-S, eaters. Aradhya, you're telling me thank you. Eaters, welcome. Then after eaters, flesh, F-L-E-S-H, flesh, F-L-E. S H flesh eaters flesh F L E S H flesh then grains G R A I N S grains G R A I N S grains flesh eaters grain eaters grains then you need to know the spelling of home also. H-O-M-E. Home. H-O-M-E. Home. Then let us learn the spellings of some animals like H-O-R-S-E. Horse. H-O-R-S-E. Horse. Horse is a plant eater. Horse is a plant eater. So let's learn the spelling of one plant eater, one grain eater. Pigeon. P-I-G-E-O-N. Pigeon. P-I-G-E-O-N. Pigeon. Horse is plant eater. Pigeon is grain eater. So, let's learn a spelling of one insect eater also. Okay, spider. Spider. S-P-I-D-E-R. Spider. S-P-I-D-E-R. Spider. Then one spelling of flesh eater, cheetah. Okay, cheetah, because it is the fastest land animal also. It is a flesh eater and also fastest land animal. So let's learn the spelling of cheetah. Hi Pranay, good morning.
Cheetah. C H E E T A H. Cheetah. C H E E T A H. Cheetah. So this is a list of 8 keywords. E A T E R S. Eaters. F L E S H. Flesh. G R A I N S. Grains. H O M E. Home. H O R S E. Horse. P I G E O N. Pigeon. S-P-I-D-E-R. Spider. Spider is an insect which has 8 legs. C-H-E-E-T-A-H. Cheetah. Cheetah is a flesh eater and it is the fastest land animal. So the other side, I am going to write question and answers.
Only 2 questions are given in your textbook. So let's write the answers for only those 2 questions. No extra question and answers. Okay.
So question and answers. Q&A is question and answers. So what is the first question? What are flesh eaters? Your first question is, what are flesh eaters? W-H-A-T. What are F-L-E-S-H? Flesh E-A-T-E-R-S. What are flesh eaters? Answer.
What are flesh eaters? What are flesh eaters? Madhav, Anahita, Pranay, Kavleen, Kavya. Who will tell me? Aradhya. What are flesh eaters? Animals. Yeah, yes. Animals which eat the flesh of other animals are called flesh eaters. Example, lion and tiger.
So I'm going to write the same.
Answer is little big. Okay, answer is little big. So when this question comes in your examination, what are flesh eaters? You can simply write animals which eat flesh of other animals. Okay. If you can stop the answer there, even then it is okay. Yes, animals which eat flesh of other animals. Only this much.
But here in the notebook, I am going to give a proper answer. Are called flesh eaters. I am going to add this sentence also. Because this is how you need to learn an answer. What are flesh eaters? Animals. A-N-I-M-A-L-S. Animals. Which eat, which eat the F-L-E-S-H, flesh of other animals. O-T-H-E-R, other, A-N-I-M-A-L-S, animals, are called flesh eaters. Are called flesh eaters. F-L-E-S-H, flesh. E-A-T-E-R-S, flesh eaters. Now, it is very good if you can cite the examples also. For example, okay, short form of example, e.g. lion and tiger. L-I-O-N, lion, and T-I-G-E-R, tiger. Lion and tiger. Answer is lengthy, children, so you may not be able to write along with me. Even then, it is okay.
If you are listening to me and looking at the board, it is still like a revision, right?
So, second question. This is, what are flesh eaters?
What is the other question given in your textbook? What are grain eaters? What are grain eaters? W-H-A-T. What are G-R-A-I-N? Grain E-A-T-E-R-S. Grain eaters? Question mark. Answer. What are grain eaters? Now tell me, what are grain eaters? Animals which eat grains are called grain eaters. So I'm going to write the same. Animals, A-N-I-M-A-L-S, animals, W-H-I-C-H, which eat G-R-A-I-N-S, grains. And see, the spelling is here in the question itself. Animals which eat grains are called grain eaters. G-R-A-I-N, grain, E-A-T-E-R-S, grain eaters. So, examples of grain eaters are birds. You can simply write birds, or you can mention the names of any two birds. Or at least if you can mention the name of one bird, still it is okay. For example, whichever is easier for you, you can write. I am writing pigeon, P-I-G-E-O-N, pigeon, and P-A-R-R-O-T, parrot. You can even write sparrow also, whichever is easier for you. Coming to the examples, whichever spelling is easier for you, that example you can mention here. What are grain eaters? Animals which eat grains. Animals which eat grains are called grain eaters. Okay. For example, pigeon and parrot. For example, pigeon and parrot. So I will erase this board. I will clear the board and write the next one. Then. The next topic is homes of animals. One side we will write the names of animals, and other side we will write the home where they live. I will send you the PDF, don't worry. Okay, then. Animals and their homes. Next topic is animals and their homes. Okay, animals and their homes. So we are going to make two columns. One side animals, okay, and the other side homes. Animals and homes. So first animal, let's take birds. B-I-R-D-S. Tell me, children, birds live in what is a home of bird called? Are your moms not there with you? Nest. N-E-S-T, nest. Okay. Birds live in nest. Birds live in nest. Yes, Kavya. Good. Then, after this, rabbit. R-A-B-B-I-T. Rabbit. Rabbit lives in burrow. B-U-R-R-O-W. Burrow. Rabbit lives in burrow. After rabbit, Lion.
Yes. Lion. What is the home of lion called?
Lion lives in?
Shed?
No. Stable? No. Hole? No. Then? Lion lives in?
Den. D-E-N. Den. Lion lives in den.
Then?
Snake. S-N-A-K-E. Snake.
Snake lives in? Snake lives in? Snake lives in? Hole.
Yeah. Snake lives in? Hole. Number five.
Then we have
cow. C-O-W. Cow.
Cow lives in? Shed. Cow lives in? Shed.
The home of cow is called shed. Cow lives in shed.
Horse lives in stable.
Horse lives in, H-O-R-S-E, horse lives in stable. S-T-A-B-L-E, stable.
S-T-A-B-L-E, stable. Horse lives in
stable.
And last one, dog.
Dog lives in kennel. K-E-N-N-E-L,
kennel. Dog lives in kennel. Birds live in nest. Birds. Let me write bird. If I write birds here, I should write nest. Bird lives in nest. Rabbit lives in burrow. Lion lives in den. Snake lives in hole. Cow lives in shed. Horse lives in stable. And dog lives in kennel. So, with this we have finished the notebook work. I will send you the PDF, children. Okay? And please finish your notebook work. And please remember that we are going to collect your notebooks from 23rd of this month. So, please sit and complete your notebook work. Okay, children? It is important to complete your notebook work. Okay? Tata, children. That's all. Kavleen has done. Okay. Tata. Bye-bye. Bye.